Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're talking to Mr. Dave Dahl. He's the man behind Dave's Killer Bread. Your father was a baker. Growing up, you had a difficult relationship, somebody might say. And did that affect what you had planned for a career? In other words, had you anticipated following in his footsteps and then you decided to strike out on your own? It seems like it must have affected your job.
Getting to the point where I was actually involved in the business and becoming disillusioned, you might say, with the whole thing. As far as a career, I never really saw myself doing it as a career. I never thought about what a career was. It was just like, this is all I knew. And when I started thinking about that I was going to get stuck in this, then I started looking at other things, but everything to me was a fantasy. It's kind of like, well, I'm going to be a basketball player or a rock star, or
other than where you were.
Yeah, I couldn't get my head around anything else but things that were iconic type stuff, you know.
Your story then took you from that house out into the world where you had what we might call a bit of a tumultuous life, and a lot of that had to do with substance abuse, drug use. How did that begin? How did drugs enter your life? Do you remember the moment where that happened? Was there
I was smoking weed, stuff like that, drinking a little bit of beer, which was pretty heavy duty for coming from where I came from. There was a lot of, maybe when I was 13, 14 years old, it kind of started later than a lot of kids I knew. I just basically did those and a little bit of cocaine through my teens, mescaline, mushrooms, things like that.
Was acid. It because you liked the way that it felt, or because you wanted to do something that was opposite to your childhood, or both?
I think I was exploring, and it made me feel different. So, but most of those drugs in my teenage years didn't have the effect that later drugs did that I found at my drug of choice. I was actually about 21 at the time that I first injected some methamphetamine. And in those days, I think the drug was a lot better than it is now anyway. I don't know if you'd actually enjoy it like I did then, if I tried it now. But it really was a sort of a eye-opener for me. It just made me start moving. It immediately, as soon as I put that on my arm, I could do anything. And
was it something you sought out, or did somebody offer it to you?
They offered it to me. I would have never sought out crank. That was what we called it in those days. I heard it was just nothing but bad news. Putting a needle in my arm, coming from where I came from, very, very edgy stuff, very off the edge. And the only reason that I ever decided to put a needle in my arm and do that drug was because I'd already basically come to the point where, because of depression and anxiety and just overall loneliness and despair and a sense of becoming very hateful towards society and all kinds of things like that, not to mention my family, it became, all of a sudden, it didn't matter anymore. And I was like, well, what do I have to lose?
Right.
And I shot up some meth, and I was like, wow, this is a feeling I've never imagined I could have. It's kind of a dream.
Sort of feeling of strength or confidence?
Strength, confidence, not being affected by any kind of fears, depression. The anxiety is a good anxiety and not a bad anxiety. That's the first thing that you get,
Did you have any awareness at that time, or did you consider the health risks, the damage that it might be doing, or was that just a price you were willing to pay? Was that a trade-off that seemed worthwhile?
It definitely was something I was willing to pay. I just didn't give a darn about anything at that point. And if we go back just a little bit, my late teenage years, I had really come to the point. I was drinking, I'd been up in jail every once in a while for some drinking or something crazy, like just get a little too crazy drinking and things like that. I didn't have a balance in my life, so I would either feel really kind of euphoric here and there, or most of the time I just felt really depressed. And so you know, I'd given up on life about 80% of the time, 80-90% of the time. So, you know, that opportunity to put that needle in my arm, it wouldn't have, you know, I wouldn't have done it at an earlier age. And when I did it this time, it just changed my life, you know.
When we come back, we'll find out where that change took you and where your personal rock bottom was and how you came out of that to create the company that created this bread that is in front of us right here that has made such an impact right here in Portland, Oregon. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay there. Be back after this.